Swole Benji here. Today in New World, we are going to talk about House Peacock score, how it's calculated, why I don't think it's being properly calculated, and how you can win the PvP house minigame so that your house is the one displayed to the public. So let's get started with talking about it. I've made a couple other videos on this channel about housing, but I have had thorough time to test this finally, and I want to share with you how this stuff works. So let's look at the house menu, okay? So right now, for this testing, I did not play on this character for 2 days. I played on other characters on other servers. So every 48 hours, the house score gets calculated, right? Based on the items in your house. So I didn't do any territory fighting. I didn't do anything to give me any kind of territory score. So the way your house score, right now I have 11,907 points. It is calculated based on your territory standing, which doing anything in the territory will get you territory standing, especially doing missions. That will give you a lot of territory standing and furniture placed in your house. So as you can see right now, I am not winning the house war. This person, Ived Daddy, has 15,155 points. So let's look at his house. So let's check out his house. Let's see. There's nothing on the front. Okay, so we go inside the house, we got a chest, a little tool thing on the wall, iron chest, so that's the only good thing so far, but that's just for storage, you know, shelves, some tables, and I think, is that it? What's he got up here? And a bed, a desk, and a drawer. So, obviously this person's house score is based on all the territory standing they did, but let me show you something else, okay? Let's go to the lowest scoring person, which has 1 point, Seabass's residence. Alright, what do they have? They have a chandelier, a table, a jug. I've never seen this blue cloth dinner plates before. You can't craft this. You can't, I don't know where this drops. They've got the quest reward dog. Let's see what they got upstairs. If they have anything. They have another desk there and a bed, which takes a good amount of resource to craft. Oh, and a net. So already, this person has way more furniture in their house, but they're only getting 1 point for it. So let's look at my house now. All right, so here's my house. I've got a box of jugs, so a bunch of jugs holding open the door, garlic wreath on the door, another wicker jug, a light. This is extending the porch. These are extending the porch, these wooden slats. I've got like wind chimes. Check it out. It's like a restaurant thing. Now this up here, this fish on the wall, this is a legendary fish. This took me over 10 hours of fishing to find, and I only found one. I got plants growing down the wall, chairs, jugs, desks, more chairs for people to sit and eat. And you know, it's supposed to look like a fish restaurant, right? This globe, no one else in the, I've looked at hundreds of houses across multiple servers. No one else has this darn globe. I've got a wreath. I've got all these papers on the wall, which are supposed to, you know, be like menus that you would see on a wall at an old-timey restaurant. A light here, another wreath. We go inside, there's carpet, a desk, a light. Looking up above, you got all the pots and pans, more pots and pans on a shelf. Dishes, a desk, stools, you know, you got place settings for your restaurant. There's a pan on the wall, another wreath. Even more, like, cookingware, two desks, a drawer. This is an ultra-rare painting also. You have to find this out in the world. Lighting, a stove, tables. Look, I got the green tablecloth. I got a red tea set. That's super rare. Very hard to get, okay? Oh, and this painting I forgot. Yeah, this painting here was a raid boss drop. So that's raid level decorations. I got the ores, more desks, beds, shelves, more stuff up there. I've got a bathtub and then a pirate jar. I've got the storage chest desk. You go upstairs, I got, you know, just basic stuff, a shelf. You guys get the point, right? Like, this is fully decked out. Now, these red curtains are another raid boss drop, okay? I have two raid boss drops in my house and some very ultra rare stuff that you can't craft. You have to find them, right? So, and I'm only getting 11,000 house score for all this, and that's without doing any territory standing. So, essentially, what this boils down to, and what I'm trying to get at, is that if you want your house to be publicly displayed, and right now this house is showing because it's my house, I will always see my own house. But to everyone else, the house that is showing is, well, this one. This one with, you know, nothing on the outside, and just your basic crap on the inside. We've already looked at it. The point is that if you want your house to be the publicly displayed house, you can't just be a good decorator or have a lot of furniture. You actually have to play the game and do territory missions. Like, here's territory standing. You know, I have 44, but every 2 days, like, these points are no longer calculated. Only what's calculated is what you end up doing in the zone. So, like, if I went fishing, clearing out corrupted areas, you know, did some farming, some gathering, some crafting, yeah, I will raise my score up. But if you aren't doing that, you won't be the publicly displayed house no matter how well you decorate it. So that's why I think it needs some work. We can look at some other people's houses too, right? Like, the only owner of this house is this guy, and you know, he's got some storage chests. I think that's all he's using his house for, which at this point, that's all I would use my house for. Right now, I'm not even planning. He's just got like pots and pans on the ground. Hey, that's cool. He's got like a little push cart. But yeah, essentially, housing, the only real use for a house is for that extra teleport, which is good. But is it rent-worthy good? Like, my base rent every week is 500 coins, okay? And I can have up to two storage chests in here. I don't even think 500 coins a week is worth the storage, because if I want storage, here's all you gotta really do. And I know this is a housing video talking about the peacocking score, but honestly, you just go to the market and you put something overpriced in the market for 28 days. So I'm just gonna show you right now to wrap up the video, because I'm a little disappointed with the housing. So I'm just gonna go to sell, and let's say I have something that I want to keep. Like, I want to keep my rawhide. I don't want to lose this, but I don't have storage space. My vaults are full, let's say I don't own a house and have extra storage. You just gotta place sell order, and then you just jack up the price. So let's say $5 each. Then you just jack it up to 28 days, and look, I'm just gonna pay 226 coins to store all this, which 1,123 rawhide, you know, that's quite a lot, right? That's a good that's a whole storage chest worth. But I get to store it for 4 weeks instead of 1 week for half the price. All right, so there we go. Now I have 4 weeks of storage in the market. And hey, if someone buys it at $5 each, I just became rich. Which I would hopefully that they wouldn't pay that much for it, but you know, just doing that alone, and you can do that 100 times. Just doing that is way better than buying a house, paying like weekly rent. You have to pay every single week, and having to buy or craft the storage chest. That's just like I see no point. Yeah, the cool thing about having a house is you can use it as an extra teleport. Well, guess what is also an extra teleport? Campfires. You know, and the cool thing is if your house is on cooldown, you can pay Azoth to get it off cooldown. So it's a cheaper teleport. But it's like, it's still, it's just not worth it. what else do I need to store? I have way too much stuff in here, because I've just been doing everything in the game. I got so much food, guys. So much alchemy and arcana parts that I can't craft anything with this stuff. It's not that I don't have the skill for it, it's just that I don't have every single little minute material required, right? And yeah, I could craft some basic stuff. Like, I have no reason to ever craft this. No reason ever. I can craft these basic potions, but I'm not gonna be using these. Like, I don't need corrupted coding. So what do? You store it, of course, but still, houses just aren't worth the cost, I don't think. And yeah, so peacock score, I was a little disappointed that the person that had a whole bunch of furniture in the house gets 1 point for it, whereas the person with barely any furniture but they're doing missions is getting all the points. I think that needs changing or looking at. I don't know if devs will ever watch this video or if anyone really cares about housing that much to make it a big deal, but that was kind of one of my main draws for playing this game since they scaled PvP and I can't grief people at level 60. So yeah, housing, it's not for me. I'm a little disappointed. Guess I'll just find something else to do. I'm Soul Benji. Thanks for watching. Here's my house. It is something I want to remember. That's kind of why I'm making the video too. I make videos for myself, but anyway, thanks for watching. As always, be a bro, stay swole. Make sure that you leave a like and a comment. Do both. It is an algorithm combo. It's a YouTube cheat code. It really helps. Also, 72% of you aren't subscribed, so please subscribe. It really helps out. I'm going to chop this bed up now. You can't actually destroy anything in your house, sadly. I mean, I can move it around and stuff, but it's whatever. So yeah, make sure you're subscribed. I put out a New World video every single day. And I plan to as long as I keep playing the game, unless something better comes along, I don't know, or if something happens to me in real life. But yeah, daily videos! Make sure you're subscribed for them. Alright, take care, lads. I'll see you in the next one.